had the chance to visit the farm while I was in Nebraska, and I got up there on a clear, beautiful day. Mike was fixing to get back into the cornfield after the 3-day delay. They had a horrendous rainstorm, 4.5 inches, I believe he said, and of course couldn't get into the field with that mud. So I got up there and we got together, and I took a walk over to the pasture, and then the next day he was able to get into the field. So I followed along with the camera and put the movie that you're watching right now. And as you can see, he is taking 4 rows of a cut here, and later on I tried to walk, or I did walk beside the combine, and it was moving at a pretty brisk pace. It was just a comfortable walking pace, but sure goes through the field fast. This is on the, as you probably surmised already, on the old Hazen farm. Later on you're going to catch a glimpse of the old Adams farm across the road. That's Dee's now, and she may notice she put up a new house over there. And anyway, back to the cornfield here. Mike figured this is going to make him about 100 bushels to the acre, which ain't bad, such as dry land. However, he did say it ought to be making dry land in the, around the countryside, so making more like 160. Corn's planted way thicker than we ever did, of course, and fertilized, and they had quite a bit of rain this summer. Anyway, you're watching the operation. This is pretty slick. The corn picker goes through the field and snatches the stalks down below the machine, and in the process snaps off the ears, and then the ears go through the combine and get shelled off of the top, and the top and the husks and whatnot. The rest of the debris get kicked out the back end, and the corn, as you'll see later in the video, goes into the hopper behind the cab of the combine. Things are really good here, sunny day, and more importantly, the corn's good and dry, the field's good and dry because they've had a lot of wind lately, and that helped dry it out. And so I just hung on and took a Christine, and because I was having to hang on, you're going to occasionally see my finger over the covering, partially covering the lens of the camera. And I just lost my head there a couple of times because I had to hang on, like I said. And the operations changed a bunch since I was on the farm. I mentioned to Mike that, you know, this is really different. When I was a little kid, we picked this stuff by hand, and he didn't even know what that meant, let alone ever having done it. But what he's doing now is picking the corn. You're going to see in a minute, we're going to dump it in a little trail, two-wheel trailer. It goes behind the tractor. As soon as that's full, we'll transfer it to the 18-wheeler truck sitting in the driveway over there on the Hazen place. And then that goes straight to the market. There's no more storing corn on the farm anymore. They just, the demand is such that they want it right now. And so it goes straight to the elevator. And so that's the end of the corn processing. All the old storage bins we used to put corn in are worthless now, or else if they were the right shape, you can now use them for a machine shed. But the pictures really turn 180 from what it used to be. That's the Adams place you see in the background over there. That's the trailer that's going to haul this corn to the 18-wheeler here pretty quick. Thank you. Well, hope you enjoyed the video. That's all, folks.